Hi Rory, thanks for coming and talking to us at Caplow today. We're looking ahead to tomorrow night when Queen's Park come here on Development League West. Before we talk about that, we want to look back at the last outing. It was a couple of weeks ago against Queen of the South, 6-4, an extraordinary match. What was your thoughts on that match and the experience? It must have been quite a crazy match to be involved in.
Yeah, it was a good experience. It was, obviously you want to win the game, but it's a good learning curve for the team anyway. To, looking back on it, we gave away some poor goals, but we, attacking wise, we created some great goals. We scored a good few, but pretty decent goals. So obviously looking back on it, we'll be thinking that we should have came away from 3 points, but on the other hand, we're still learning. It's an under-20s game, and we need, obviously if you want to make the next step, you need to be able to see them games out, so maybe one of them ones that gives you the chance to.
It's interesting for like a neutral watching the game or myself up in the press box, you're looking and you're thinking 6-4, it's 10 goals, it's the way it's happened, but you as a player, is it more, are you angry because you just think, well, we were 4-1 up and we've lost 6-4 and can see the 6 goals, or just, you don't care about what other people think about 6-4, you're just thinking, well, we've lost a match, is that the way you looked at it?
It was quite annoying, obviously, to lose so many goals. Obviously, we probably should have seen the game to bed anyway, but I just, one of them ones, it's very, very rarely happens that you're going to lose 4 goals in the space of 15 minutes at the end of the game, but just one of them ones, we need to take the chin, bounce back.
Is that what did Darren say to you? Is that Darren Barr? He would have maybe said a learning curve for you, is that?
Yeah,
to Darren. Just because it is under 20s level?
Obviously, he was disappointed as well. He was playing, he's going through the same emotions as us when he's on pitch, so he was quite disappointed in losing, but at the end of the day, he's got his. He told us it's a learning curve, just as long as we're learning from it, we'll be fine, because obviously it's a pretty decent, got a good 20s team this year, so it should be a pretty good team.
James McFadden obviously played in the game, scored 4 goals. Was that an experience coming up against James McFadden, a guy you probably watched as a young boy on the telly, playing for Scotland and stuff like that?
Aye, it was a good experience. He's one of them players that he always associates with Scotland, obviously his goal against France and whatever, but aye, it was good to play against him because obviously he's got that international experience of playing Premier League and whatever, so he's scoring 4 goals, he showed his class anyway. So.
You don't expect that in a development game as well, do you know, he'd be playing against a player like that,
John
Duffy mentioned that. So.
Obviously you might get the odd one or two, there's maybe back for injury or trying to stay fit or whatever, but McFadden have played, it's obviously a bit different from playing against some other ones, it's maybe just getting in the first team and are still maybe 21, 22, so. It was a good experience, obviously, to play against the player that you've watched growing up.
It's Queen's Park here tomorrow night. Queen's Park are top of the league. They're 6 points ahead of you guys at the moment. You have got a game in hand. What's your thoughts going out in that game? It's obviously a different game.
Should be a good game, obviously. They're sitting top of the league at the minute, so they'll be a good team anyway. It's just about how we go into the game. Obviously, if we go into the game playing well, start well, we would assume that we're going to win the game anyway. Because it's the feeling we've got at the minute that most games we're going to win, but Queen's Park are still going to be a decent challenge anyway. They like to keep the ball, they're very technically good players, so it should be a good game anyway tomorrow night.
On an individual level, how have you felt yourself this season? You're obviously on the first team bench and you're in amongst the first team squad. How have you been feeling?
Yeah, I thought I had a good start anyway. Obviously, in some of the 20s games, I've maybe had to play up position at centre back again, but it's the games I've played in Saturday, I'd have felt as if I'd done well, obviously. I sat here against East Kilbride, I should have scored that. Could go on off a bar down here, and then the Queen of South game, scoring one, setting up one. Have another one over the line, which I didn't give either as well. But I feel as if I've had a good start to the season, obviously. Training with the first team, being about the first team, it gives you that, it makes you want to go and push on harder to at least maybe get 10 minutes at the start with on the pitch with the first team on Saturday.
You've seen that with Ben Armour, Ben's obviously on the bench where he's been getting on. Is that something you look at and you think that's what you want to emulate, you want to do as well?
Yeah, 2 years of feels like we're on the same boat at a minute, so it's always pleasing to see my pal getting on, getting some game time and coming on doing well as well, especially against Dundee United. But hopefully the season goes on and we'll get more and more chances to do this.
Excellent, Rory, thank you very much for your time and good luck tomorrow night.
Cheers, John.